Understanding the topic of data architecture, let alone mastering it, can seem daunting. First, there's understanding the real purpose behind data architecture. Then there's the issue of designing it to best meet that purpose. There are many facets to consider: robustness, scalability, reusability, traceability, and more. So to introduce some basic concepts of good design, let's look at something a little more familiar to us in our daily lives. Let's visit the grocery store. But this grocery store is not quite the same grocery store that you know. Instead, it has been designed like a classic data model. This store is organized by recipe rather than ingredient, so that if you needed to make dinner for the week, you could find, for example, a meatloaf aisle, a chili aisle, or a lasagna aisle. Each of these aisles have pre-packaged, ready-to-go boxes that contain all of the ingredients that you will need for each recipe. In theory, this would be very convenient. If you want to make chili, you walk into the store, go directly to the chili aisle, and take a chili box off the shelf. Only a single box from a single aisle is needed, making your ingredients easy to obtain in no time. But what if you wanted to make Texas chili rather than just regular chili? Texas chili is a little different and requires ingredients that are not in the regular chili box. Texas chili uses cubed beef instead of ground beef. This means that the grocery store will need to make a Texas chili aisle to be able to provide the ingredients necessary for that specific recipe. So now we need two different aisles, but Texas chili and regular chili have most of the same basic ingredients, like canned tomatoes, garlic, and onions. All of those ingredients need to be available in both aisles. And although these recipes can be used by different people, the ingredients from each box cannot be used interchangeably. So while meatloaf, regular chili, and lasagna all call for ground beef, you could not use the ground beef from the lasagna box for the chili. You can see where this becomes quite complicated and redundant. As if this problem wasn't enough, let's now consider what would happen if one of those redundant ingredients needed to change. For example, what happens if all canned tomatoes produced by a certain provider are recalled? Every recipe box that contains tomatoes would need to be identified, located, and the canned tomatoes swapped for a new brand. Plainly, this is neither efficient nor convenient. But what if, instead, our grocery store was organized by commonality, with one aisle for produce, one aisle for meats, another for spices, and so on? This allows for reuse of individual ingredients, and for easy change to your recipes as well. These recipes would no longer be maintained by the grocery store at all, and any shopper with any recipe could use the store to find their ingredients. That sounds better, doesn't it? And of course, this is pretty much how our corner grocery stores are organized now. Let's go back to data architecture, and for the sake of analogy, let's think of the grocery store as a data model, the recipes as messages, and the ingredients as data fields. Using the grocery store as an example, we can start to understand how critical it is to build data models with reusability and future expandability in mind. Designing grocery stores around recipes is like designing data models to mirror the structure of messages. This approach constrains the cook to specific recipes, and using a new recipe means creating a new aisle every time. In the same way, even though this is a common error in the way that data models are designed, this type of data model constrains the ability for future messages to utilize the data model without the data model respectively needing to change. Organizing by commonality allows for reuse and decreases redundancy too, since we don't need canned tomatoes in 50 aisles, we only need them in one. In the data model, we also dramatically decrease the level of effort required to modify data or a characterization within the model. Because a characterization occurs only once within the model, a change to that characterization only needs to occur in that one location. And not only does a data model structured by commonality enable full reusability of data, it also allows full traceability between messages, since all messages utilize the same data within the model. An appropriately structured data architecture allows for complete scalability of the model, reusability of the data across messages, and traceability between messages. A solution like this saves time, money, and allows for more innovative use of the architecture and its data.